Okay, so it's time to do a quick tutorial on how to use equatorial mode now that it's finally out for the C-Star. And keep in mind that you can do this whether on your S50 or on your S30. I'll be showing step by step the S50. DWO has already taken out their own brief video that explains really well how to do equatorial mode, but let's go ahead and go step by step as to what you're gonna need and how to set it up. And what we're gonna do is, and what I want all of you to do is to make sure that you first set this up during the daytime, whether it's outside or inside your home, but just make sure you do this setup that I'm about to show right now at the beginning first during the daylight, so that way it'll be a lot easier once you go out at night. You won't be fumbling around and trying to work it out that way. Okay, and one more thing that I'd like for you to keep in mind is that since this is just for demonstration purposes, most likely your tripod will be a lot higher than this. You're not gonna wanna have one this low. I'm using the Celestron, a Celestron tripod that I already have for another telescope, since I believe it's going to be a little bit more sturdier than putting my S50 on the stock tripod. Now, some people are using their S30 with the S50 stock tripod and even putting a weight on it, and that's up to you if you'd like to try that, but you know, do it at your own risk. Make sure you're making sure that this isn't tilting over, it's not falling, and things like that, but you're most likely you're going to want to get a more sturdy tripod that can handle this equatorial mode. And another thing is, like I said, this is going to be more raised, and your tripod leg should be facing north as well. And another thing to keep in mind is that you're going to want the power button of the C-Star to also face up. Now, your C-Star app actually tells you this. It'll show you a brief tutorial very easily how to do that, but just for something, just to keep it in mind, I'll show you how it is that I have my C-Star this way, how I got it to this point. But you're gonna want, whether it's your S50 or your S30, you're gonna want these to point up once you have it ready, right before you start the equatorial mode function. And on top of that, you're going to want your the head of your C-Star to basically face the North Pole as well, which you can use the star Polaris as your guide. By the way, if you're wondering how to protect your C-Star in between your sessions, we all know that sometimes our C-Star can get scratched. I know it's happened to me when I've had it perhaps laying against a wall. I had not realized that my C-Star had gotten scratched somehow. Also to protect it from dust, besides having like a lens cap on your C-Star, something that the Astro Room has handmade is these really cool, really nice C-Star protection covers. And I have it both for the S50 and for the S30. Feel free to place your orders now. These are actually made to order, handmade to order. So feel free to place your orders and check them out, the link on the description. But they basically go on like this, super simple. And it's basically to protect it from dust and scratches. They come in two different colors, both for the S50 and for the S30. And what's great about it is that they are very custom fit. It's a perfect custom fit. Like I said, these are handmade, so they are fit specifically for your S50 or for your S30. I'm ready to send these out to some of you that have already ordered. And here's how it looks on the S30. So like I said, they come in two different colors. So what you want to do is keep this covered in between your sessions, right? You know, sometimes we can't image every single night due to the weather, due to clouds, different things, right? So once you bring your C-Star back inside and you're done imaging for the night, you're gonna wanna put your cover on it till it's ready to be used again. So check it out. Now, I'm not going to talk to you about what exactly equatorial mode is. I feel like there's already plenty of videos that explain that. Not only that, but ZWO has done a video themselves in their tutorial about EQ mode, which explains the reasons why you will want to use this. But I will say just one thing. Once you start using it, you will never want to go back to the regular mode. And the reason why is one reason only why, but there's plenty. But one of them would be that your images will be a lot better. You will notice a difference. You should notice a difference in your image quality and the look of your images will just be significantly better. Not only that, but once we get to use the 60 seconds exposure mode, which ZWO has already confirmed they will provide that feature, it's just going to be even better. For now, we can use a 30 second mode, but once we can get to 60, get ready. It's gonna be amazing. Okay, so let's start out with how I do step-by-step of how to set up the equatorial mode. And keep in mind that if you haven't tried this yet, it might sound or seem very overwhelming. Once you get the hang of it, it should only take you just the same amount of time that you pretty much did before when you used a regular mode for your C-Search. So maybe just a couple minutes. It shouldn't take that long once you get used to it. But the sooner that you can start learning how to use this, the better it's going to be for you as ZWO continues to update and give us more and more features to make this EQ mode even better, okay? So you're going to want to start getting the hang of it right now. And let's go ahead and start. So I'm using the leveler still. And one of the reasons why I want this the C-Start to be as raised as possible, besides the fact that, of course, once you put your EQ wedge on it, right, it will already be really pretty high up. But one of the reasons why I do want this on here is because your C-Start, remember, it's going to be tilted. So depending on where you live to, your latitude, right, your coordinates, for some it might not be as tilted, but you're just going to want to make sure that your C-Start won't hit your tripod as it starts doing the EQ mode and it starts spinning around and moving. You want to make sure it's not hitting any parts of your tripod. So, you know, I like to just have the leveler already on there. So I installed that on my tripod. And then on top of that, what I'm using is the Skywatcher wedge. Now, ZWO has mentioned that they will come out with their own wedge. As of the date of this video, it's going to be about another month or so before they do that. But in the meantime, you can use what a lot of people are using, which is the Skywatcher wedge, which is a very good wedge still, no matter what. So let me go ahead and show you what I do. So like I said, I put the leveler. After I put the leveler, I put my wedge on here. And this particular wedge actually comes with a knob that once you have that knob on there, what's going to happen, it doesn't come with this knob. I got this separately. I'll show you why. So once you have that knob on there, what's going to end up happening with your C-Star is once you mount it, it's going to hit it. It's going to hit it as it's turning. It's just not going to be able to do its rotation. It's not going to leave you enough space on there. So what I did is I got this separately, and I'll put a link in the description for you to get this. You can use any other kind of bolt that's this size. You don't have to buy this particular one. This one is pretty bulky. It sticks out a lot, but I mean, it's up to you what you want to use. And the wedge will come with this safety lock, right, which will prevent your C-Star from sliding and falling. Okay, so this is the safety lock. And something that I noticed is that with the safety lock, I actually ended up getting another little piece. You can go to your local hardware store. You're going to want to do this. Yeah, so this will actually, if you don't put that stopper on there, this washer, what's going to happen is that this thread is going to come out too high and it'll actually hit your C-Star. It'll start scratching the bottom of your C-Star and you're not going to want that. So that's why you're going to want to get a washer to stop that action. Okay, so after you've set that on here, what you're going to want to do is put the security lock on your C-Star. Okay, so you're going to want to put it in like that. Right, make sure it's secure. You're going to want to make sure that this is secure when you put it on there. And one way is by using a little Allen hex key. So you can put that in there to make sure, or you can use a hexagon tip or a little screw there, right, to be able to make sure that it's tightened. You don't have to overly tighten it, just to make sure, you know, it's a good, you feel that nice tension there. So once you have that on there, then you can slide the C-Star in. Okay, there we go. And then once you have that, that's where your bolt comes in. Okay, your bolt, you're going to tighten it with this. Okay, and you see the seesaw is still loose. I'm not done yet, right? This is still very loose, so that's why you have these knobs here. But with these knobs here, you're gonna wanna make sure that you have right about even room between left and right, because the SeaStar app, once it tells you to start moving things around, you're gonna wanna make sure that you just kinda even right here, okay? So just give yourself enough room. Don't make one side longer, too long or too short than the other, you know, just try to make it, you know, as even as you can. So, okay, so like I said, this is still loose. And like, remember that the SeaStar has to tilt, right? The SeaStar has to tilt. So this is what we're gonna do. This is loose. Make sure this is loose. Before you start moving this knob, this has to be loose, okay? Okay, so you wanna do this during the day, like I said, because you don't wanna be fumbling around with this during the daytime. So as you see, I'm moving the SeaStar body. This is going down, right? The SeaStar where the power button is, you're gonna want that to point up. Okay, you don't want this the other way, right? Pointing down to the ground. You want this to face up towards the sky. You want the head of the SeaStar up here to be pointing north. Once we have that, we want to secure. Okay, and you'll feel the tension. You'll feel the tension. Now you can secure it with that wedge right there, with that knob right there. And, you know, you can check all your knobs just to make sure we're good. Nothing's going to fall. Everything is nice and tight. The bottom where my leveler was, yep, we're good, we're good. This should be good to go. And now we should be able to try it outside.
Okay, so we're outside now. It's nighttime and I'm already using EQ mode. And you know that because of the way my telescope is facing and it's actually green. The green light here will let you know you're in EQ. When it's yellow, it's not in EQ mode, but on regular mode. So the way that I did this is you're gonna go to your advanced features in your app. And in your advanced features, once you get to that, you're going to see something that says mount mode. You're going to press on mount mode, which we'll see. You'll see that it'll take you to a different menu that's your EQ mode. And on your EQ mode, it shows you exactly what I was showing you while we were indoors, which is you want now your SeaStar to be facing up. You want the power button to be facing the sky. Not how it is right now. Since I'm already using EQ mode, you're going to want this to be facing up, right? Your power button, and you're gonna want this body of your SeaStar, just like you're seeing in the diagram, right? The body, the top head part of the SeaStar, you want it to be facing Polaris, right? North, which is the Polaris star. What you're gonna wanna do while you're in this menu is, you see where it says your current latitude, mine is telling me that it's 34 degrees. You're gonna put it to whatever by using the knobs, by tilting your SeaStar, right, up and down. You're going to use those knobs to put it to your own current latitude of where you are, as close as you can to that. Better for you to put it exactly as how it says. Once you have it to that, you're going to click on switch. And once you click on switch, you're going to see another pop-up that comes up. This pop-up will tell you that your SeaStar needs to go back to its home position. And you're just going to press OK. You're going to let the SeaStar be on its home position. It might already be at that position. Just press OK. And then when you're done with that, you're going to tell your SeaStar to get polar aligned deviation. Once you hit polar aligned deviation, what's going to happen is your SeaStar will start to rotate. And it's going to take three pictures of the sky. It's going to stop briefly for a few seconds, one by one, as it looks at your sky to align your scope, right? And when it's done doing that, you're going to see your error of how far off you are from the degrees. So you're going to want to get those red numbers to as close to 0.0 as possible, right? You might not have it perfect exactly at 0.0. You're going to want to get it as close to 0.0 as possible. And once you have it to that, by whether switching the knobs, moving it up and down, left or right, once you have it at that, it'll give you a beautiful little green check mark. And then that means you're ready to go. You can actually exit that menu and go to your SkyLS, choose an object, do whatever you need to do.